This video lecture is going to cover the 5 stages of design thinking, including empathy, define, ideate, prototype, and test. As a process, these 5 stages are going to be not considered as a linear process. These are all non-linear process. Design thinking is a non-linear process. So what happens in the stage 1, which is named as empathize? Empathize means understanding the person for whom we are going to design a product or service. So learning about the customer for whom you are designing. Here you require to observe, and also you require to gather the information, keeping yourself in shoe of the customer and understand their pains as what they wanted to resolve, and try to understand the gains what they are able to witness to be enhanced. By keeping those things into consideration, trying to make immersing yourself into a customer and understanding them from their point of view rather than judgmental. A deep understanding of the problems and realities of the people whom you are designing for. The second stage is define stage, where you need to realize the needs what is being gathered from the customer in empathy stage, and keep a proper focus and provide the focus to your own team members to give their attempt on how do they able to see the solutions by keeping the framework in the form of POV. POV means point of view. So making a concise and a unique problem formulation from the voice of the customer or a client or a customer that is closer to the needs of the people. This is a process what it happens in defined stage. So we require to redesign and focusing the questions based on the insights from empathy. You could see here, what does she need? From this observation, she is trying to take out a book which is positioned much high location. She is again using certain books to keep in a stacked way and trying to use it as a table or a stool to rise onto that to reach the location where she need to pick up. So by seeing this particular thing, what you could understand and what is the need of that particular person when he wanted to understand, when he wanted to get the satisfied with the solution what you are going to provide. Third stage is about ideation, where we'll come across generating lot many ideas which could possible to be addressing the problem what is being defined, and brainstorming and coming up with creative solutions by using different ideation techniques like mind mapping or six hats or analogy or opposite thinking, or it could be like a brain walk or brain dump. There are many ideation techniques which could be taken into consideration by the team of designers and able to put forth their thinking process and come out with the solutions which could be generated in multiple number. And next stage is called the prototype. After generating multiple ideas, thereafter you require to see what are the ideas are feasible, viable, technologically feasible and economically viable. So these two categories when you are able to look at, so then you will try to certify the number of ideas, and you will try to screen out the ideas and try to take out some of the concepts along with you by cross checking them either in a low fidelity manner or high fidelity manner, or it could be like a paper prototyping or digital prototyping or 3D printing, or it could be like a HTML prototyping. Different type of prototyping approaches which could be used for making your concept will go through or will it be having any issues. That could be taken care in prototyping process, where you'll be building a representation of one or more ideas to show to others and make them to feel convinced about what thought process that you are having. And also this IDEO, as mentioned, if a picture is worth of 1,000 words, then a prototype is worth of 1,000 meetings. If you make out one prototype and it is as if equivalent to conduct of 1000 meetings among the team members to explain about what has been achieved. So fifth stage is called as a test, where the prototypes, whatever has been made, you are taking them to the original user group and testing your ideas for getting the feedback from the original user group. If you are not prepared to be wrong, you will never come up with anything original. And if it is going to be the constructive criticism which is going to be helping the products to become much better and could be acceptable by every user. So this particular design thinking, which already been mentioned, it as a non-linear process, either from defined stage, if you are not able to properly formulate the problem, you can again go back to the empathize stage, and again you relook into what is the understanding that has been made by you after hearing the customer, and again you reformulate your POVs, or either you can from test phase also you will be in a position to come back to the ideation or prototype to ideation. From prototype, what has been verified, you may come out with a composite concepts which could help you to spark your new ideas, and tests may really reveal the better ideas to redefine your problem. Okay, and tests may create new ideas for the project, or it could be making the people to relook into their the needs to be reframed. All these things may happen based on stage, what has been observed in at any level of stage, and again trying to take that as a feedback in a previous stages. And also we could call it as a divergence and convergence model, where problem space exploration, solution space exploration. Problem space exploration need to be increasing complexity, where you require to make out the problem to be more messy, so that you will be in a position to address in a more generic way, so that not only specified needs, you can make the needs beyond what is being specified, and you could cater the requirements much more than what has been expected. Coming to the solution space exploration, where you require to ensure the certainty with your convergent divergence approach, you should ensure the certainty to be increased, and you are able to get again after making out lot more ideas to emerge out. Thereafter again you need to use the prototyping approach to bring down that ideas to the minimal. Thereafter you'll be fine-tuned with the testing, and again sending it to the next downstream requirements or process. So today we have seen about the five stages of product development process, design thinking, starting from empathize, second stage define, ideation, prototyping, and testing. And also we mentioned about design thinking is a non-linear process.